Been in so many iconic roles over the years, from Ginger Snaps to Hannibal to American Mary. What's the which one is the one that you get most recognized for?
I think Ginger Snaps still to this day, because it was such a culty kind of hit. We really didn't think anyone was going to watch it. We're like, we really like this, but this is super weird. This is before like werewolves and shit like that was like cool, right? And we knew we loved it, but we weren't entirely sure that other people would. And no one watched it for like 2 years. We did a little festival circuit. And then it was, yeah, it was a couple years later, people would be like, Ginger? And I was like, what? You saw that? That's so weird. And now it just, like, it keeps ramping up. And now there's kids who, like, you weren't born when that came out, and you love that movie. And I think it is a sort of timeless classic horror film about, you know, puberty and the weird things it does to your body. And the classic, like, the werewolf. And the werewolf is so good. It was all practical effects. There was no CGI. So it still stands up when you watch it today. You don't notice that it's like almost 20-year-old movie, you know? So, Ginger Snaps definitely get recognized for, I mean, a lot of time people don't know why I look familiar to them, and they think maybe we've gone to school together or something. And I'm like, I don't know. No, I don't know. Actually, I'm an actor. You've seen me on something, murdering somebody. It's like, it's an awkward conversation, but, yeah, generally Ginger Snaps, I think. Or the Selena Gomez movie, Another Cinderella Story. All my friends' kids are like obsessed with it.
What was it like for you being in a film that dealt with the ideas of menstruation and PMS and also being a werewolf?
Yeah, I mean, I guess it didn't really strike me as odd or different. Again, I was like 17. I had not watched every horror, werewolf, menstruation, puberty movie that did exist at all. So I wasn't really aware of how different or special that was, really. I mean, I just thought the metaphor was so dead on. Like, it just kind of made complete sense to me. I was like, it's weird. No one has done this before. You know what I mean? I do know that I did have to rape one of my good friends in the back of a Volvo when I was 17 and still a virgin and very confused about what we were supposed to be doing. And I asked our driver, I was like, I didn't drink alcohol at the time, but I was like, I need a little something. Got me a little, like, something really easy, like a little glass of rosé or something to just loosen me up so I can go rape this friend of mine in the back of a Volvo as I morph into a werewolf. And he comes back with a Mickey of hot cinnamon fireball whiskey, and I'm just sitting like alone in my trailer, like trying to sip like the most like painful drink and be like, I can do this. I'm going to rape Jesse. I got this. And yeah, to this day, I still give him shit about that. It's pretty funny.
Sometimes the horror genre gets a bad rap for how it treats women. Do you think that's a label it deserves, or do you think that's another misunderstanding of the genre as a whole?
I mean, I think there are, it's definitely deserved in some points. I think a lot of people are making great steps towards sort of changing that. And like in the things that I've done in American Mary and Ginger Snaps and Hannibal, that is not the case, you know, and I really feel that. And I mean, there's a lot of horror stuff where I just look at it and go like, there's nothing really redeeming for me as a woman in horror in this. It is just, you know, victim number, whatever type thing. So I think we're getting better at that. I think, you know, in the past, there's been great female characters in horror and, you know, not so great female characters in horror, but female characters in general are getting better these days, not just in horror. So I think across the board, we're leveling up.
Do you think that the current horror genre is still giving us those kinds of powerful kind of social messages, and do you think it should be?
I think it should be. I don't know that I watch enough horror movies to know that we're like, that's really what's going on. I believe and I hope it is. But again, I mean, regardless of whether it's horror or anything, a great story, a great message, a great parable and a metaphor and anything, when you can really make it connect with someone, and you know, you're like, oh, okay, we all get puberty and we all have our bodies morph into something we're not totally thrilled with sometimes, you know, it's scary. And I think the more you can connect that way, regardless of whether it's horror or anything else, like a good story is a good story. And I think that's what we all need. We need good characters. We need good stories. And we need to have some fun.